Now let's take a look at readability and commenting in Java code. So I'll create another class, public class, and then I'll give it a name, and I'll call this one readability fun. And then I've been putting my curly braces at the end of the line. That's probably not good practice. I probably ought to take this curly brace and put it under the line, and the reason is it makes it a lot easier to find as you're trying to find the match for this curly brace. Where is it? If they're on that same level, then it's really easy visually to see where it is. And curly brace errors are a really common error, especially for beginning programmers. And so I'm going to put the beginning brace there, I'm going to put the closing brace there, and then again I'm going to indent now to say this next section of code is part of that readability fun class. The general rule of thumb is whenever we have an opening brace we're going to indent, and whenever we have a closing brace we're going to outdent. Is that a word? I think it is actually. And then if we had something below this then or above it, it would be at the same level because it's not part of that class. But the stuff that is part of that class, we're going to indent to show that it's part of that. Okay, and then I've got my line public static void main string args, and again I'll come down and put an opening curly brace and then a closing curly brace, and then automatically I know I need to indent because now this code is going to be part of this main method. And again, Java doesn't care about this. Java will compile and run the program if it's all at the same level of indentation or even on the same line as we showed before. But for us, I now know just by the indentation that this code is part of the readability fun class and the main method in the readability fun class. I can see that visually because it's laid out that way. So the indentation is a really important thing, not for the computer, but for us as humans to be able to go in and see and interpret the code. It just makes it a lot easier visually to see what's going on. So now let me go ahead and do something in this code. So I'll print something out. This is some text. And then I'll print some more stuff. This is some more text. Okay, so if I go and save this program now again I'm going to save this as the same name that I named my class, readabilityfun.java. I'll go ahead and save that and then compile the code, which will compile it to something the computer understands, and then I can run that compiled code and I'll get that text printed out that I've just printed. And so this is a fairly readable program. My indentation is good, my braces are good, and then I've used some white space. And a lot of this comes down to your own personal preference and personality, but the idea is we want to make this code as visually easy to read as possible. Okay? That's the concept. And by the way, speaking of visually easy to read, I've got something distracting going here because I'm recording my screen, but behind my recording I've got this Bing desktop that rotates every day, a new picture every day, and this is what I'm staring at behind you. Yeah. How can you not be distracted by that? This guy looks like he's had his hair styled a little bit. This guy does not look happy that the picture's being taken. I don't know what's going on over here. Anyway, sorry. I'm trying not to become distracted. The code here, we want it to be easy to read, and one thing that helps us with that is commenting in the code. And so we have a way to tell Java, I want to put a note in here, but I don't want you to do anything with it. I want it to be stripped out when you compile the program. It's just for me as a human to read. And the way that we indicate that is that there's two ways to put a comment in the program. The first way is to put two forward slashes. And you'll notice as soon as I did that second forward slash, it turned orange, and then any text that I put in here, is going to turn orange. And so I can put a comment in here. I can say print some stuff. Well, that's not very descriptive, so it's probably not actually very helpful. And more importantly, it's probably pretty obvious that's what I'm doing here is printing some stuff. So I don't know that I need that exact comment. But that's the way that we do it in the program. We can say, this is what's happening in the program. And we don't want to comment every line because, first of all, again, it's kind of obvious what's happening. But second of all, if we put too many comments in the program, it actually hurts readability, right? It makes the program more difficult to read. So we don't want to do that either. Enough to kind of introduce what's happening in the next section and kind of walk the user through the program, get information from the user and then have a section that's going to do that. Might be 10 lines of code. And then the next section. Now we're going to calculate whatever it is we're trying to calculate for this user. We're going to calculate their grade. And then you go into that section of code do the things you need to do to calculate the code. And just a line here and a line there to kind of walk someone who's looking at your code what's happening in the program, as if you were kind of walking them through it. The other thing that we can do is do block comments. If we want to comment multiple lines of code, we can do that by doing a forward slash and then an asterisk, which says start a comment. Now you'll notice everything below that turned orange now because that was just the start of the comment. If I want to comment out these two lines of code, then the closing comment is just the opposite. It's an asterisk and a forward slash, and that says that's the end of the comment. This code now will no longer be executed. And so if I try and compile and run this program, it's no longer going to print anything out because those lines of code have been commented out. And so we can do that to block out lines of code. I'll go ahead and put my print some stuff comment back in and then I'll get rid of that. One other thing that we do often is because there are many different people that are working on a program, generally you'll be working in some sort of a team with programming, and in order to know who did what and when, a lot of times we'll do a big block comment, so a forward slash and then an asterisk, and then we put in a row of asterisks, and then we'll come down and kind of the way of doing this is to put a few asterisks in there and then a bunch of asterisks to close and then a closing brace, and that creates a little block comment at the top of the code where I can then go in and say this is the readability fun.java code was written by Spencer Hilton, and we can even include a date, you know, or other information that's pertinent to this code. When was it written? And then maybe a little note about what the program does. This class helps us learn about readability. Or something about that. So that somebody coming into this class, and when I talk about somebody, I'm not talking about just some stranger coming in and looking at your code. It can be a team member or something to try and see what's happening in your code. But more importantly, it can be yourself. You'd be surprised at how much you can forget, after a matter of a couple months when you haven't looked at your code. You get a bug in the program. Somebody calls in and says, there's something wrong. My program's not running right. You go back into your own code and you say, what was I doing here? That's why we include comment blocks and commenting in the end of the code. Well, a lot of times, it makes life easier if we say, this is the end of the main method, and this is the end class readability fun. We can make notes to ourselves to keep track of what brace goes to what, and that makes life a little bit easier as well. And so, if we look at this program as a whole, it's a lot more readable now than it was before because I'm kind of walking myself through the program. And you can thank me later. This is having a lot of my career in programming was spent going into code that had already been written by somebody else and updating it to whatever new version of whatever we were writing the system in. And you get a real appreciation for readability that way. It's really difficult to go into somebody else's code and to figure out what they're doing if they haven't done this, and if the readability is not good in terms of spacing and braces and all of that. And so readability is something that, in my mind, is a critical component of programming. Hopefully that's helpful, and I'll go ahead and end there. Spencer out.